I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have prayed to you. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, as a Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me.
One God forever and ever. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, then he will sit on his glorious throne. Before him will be gathered all the nations, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he will place the sheep on his right, but the goats on the left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you clothed me. I was sick and you visited me. I was in prison and you came to me. Then the righteous will answer him, saying, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you a drink? And when did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? And when did we see you sick or in prison and visit you?" And the king will answer them, "Truly I say to you, as you did it one of the least of these my brothers, you did it to me." Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and he gave me no food. I was thirsty, and he gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and he did not welcome me. Naked, and he did not clothe me. Sick and in prison, and he did not visit me." Then they will also answer, saying, "Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not minister to you?" Then he will answer them, saying, "Truly I say to you, as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it for me." And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, when giving the first Holy Communion, children and their parents and relatives, all of us would have played or at least have seen the playing cards. A traditional set of playing cards consists of 52 cards. This deck of 52 cards is divided into four suits: spades, clubs, diamonds and hearts. Each of the suits have a king: the king of spades, king of clubs, king of diamonds and king of hearts. These 52 cards could be compared to the 52 Sundays of the liturgical year. Each of these Sundays have been dealt out, and today we are on the last Sunday. And on this last Sunday, the last card of the deck is held up, the King of Hearts. Yes, we are on the last Sunday of the liturgical year, the Feast of Christ the King. This feast is a relatively new feast. It was established by Pope Pius XI in 1925 through an encyclical letter in Latin, Quas Primas, which is, when translated into English, means in the first. Quas Primas means in the first. In the history of the Church, liturgical feasts are being instituted in answer to particular needs that arise in the life of the world and the Church. This feast of Christ the King was in response to the grave and disturbing situation of the world. The world in 1925 was still recovering from the grave and disturbing situation of the world. First World War had just ended, and that's why the world was facing a disturbing situation. Nations had been devastated, new weapons and armory had been introduced, a web of terror and danger was still vivid, modernity had crept the human mind. It was at the height of secularization of this world that we were presented the great feast of Christ the King. This feast reminds us that Christ still reigns above all. Christ is the source of every intelligence and intellect. Christ is the powerhouse of every discovery and invention. Christ is the ultimate in conquering any difficulties or any problems. The kingdom of Christ the King is under several threats today. As Christians, we are soldiers belonging to the kingdom of God, and Christ is our King. A soldier ought to be one who is deeply convinced of his faith and highly passionate about his King and his kingdom. As a Christian, am I passionately convinced of my faith and love for Christ and his kingdom? As a Christian, am I passionately enthusiastic to live my Christian virtues in this world? There are many who say that they are willing to give up their lives for Christ. They want to die for Christ. But today the Lord also demands, are you willing to live for Christ? There is an urgent need to become Christ the King's witnesses in this world, living witnesses in this world. Kings are often identified with a lot of pomp and grandeur and power and triumphalism. Then what is the identification of Christ the King? In Matthew chapter 2 verse 2, we read this question. Where is the newborn King of the Jews? And the answer to this question is found at the end of the Gospel with Jesus hanging on the cross with a statement which reads in Matthew chapter 27 verse 37, this is the King of Jews. Where the cross is, there Christ the King is. Where the cross is, there is Christ the King. Where the lost, where the sinful, abandoned and lonely are, there is Christ the King. Where the poor, the suffering, abandoned and abused are, there is Christ the King. The cross is the identity, cross is the symbol of Christ the King. As this crucified King's soldiers, we too are invited to share the cross of Christ. Yes, let us hearken to his voice, Christ the King, the great King. Christ the King has no land to reign, but he wants to reign in our hearts. Christ the King has no majestic throne, but cross is his throne. Christ the King has no mighty army, only a few people to spread his word. 16, this Christ the King invites us to renew our commitment to Him. Royalty will be less, but faithfulness is assured. Popularity will be very rare, but blessings are plenty. Shall we say yes to this King of hearts? Christ the crucified King, happy feast to all those valiant and faithful soldiers of Christ, the awesome King. At the same time, today, we celebrate the sacrament of the Holy Eucharist and give first Holy Communion to 23 children of our parish. My dear children, this day is yours. The church is almost full. Due to Corona, we understand. We have decorated the altar with flowers because today is your first Holy Communion Day. We are all here, your friends, relatives, parents, parishioners, priests, for you. We are here for you. All this looks beautiful. Church looks beautiful. The altar looks very beautiful. But for me, you all look all the most beautiful and graceful. With this white dress, you all look like angels. You all look like princes and princesses. Today, all of you shine like beautiful flowers in the garden. We are here to pray for you all. Let's say you are an uncle, you are an aunt, or your cousins want to come to your house. What will you or your parents do? I'm sure they will start preparing. They will start preparing chicken kebab, chicken biryani, fish fry. They will start preparing pets also, because uncle and an aunt will be coming home. Let's say your parish priest, Father Manohar, wants to come home. Now the preparations will increase automatically. You will clean the house, clean the altar, and also prepare some snacks and coffee for him and wait for his arrival. Surely you will do that. Now let's say your Archbishop, His Grace Peter Machar, wants to come to your house. Rarely they come, we know that. Now the preparations will be much more. Maybe you will start preparations will start from the gate room, clean the gate, put out the red carpet maybe, and then you will clean the house, surely you might wash the walls maybe. Preparations will be all the more because the Archbishop will come to our house. If Pope says, he will never come to you. Okay, if Pope says, Pope Francis says that I will come to your house, I am sure you will be preparing much more and more. For months and days, years together maybe. If after a year he comes, he will be there, you will start preparing. Today Jesus, who is greater than the Pope, greater than the Archbishop Cardinals, greater than the priests and relatives, is your Lord and friend, is going to come into your heart. How much more preparations one need to do for his arrival? I know that you have already made many preparations to receive Jesus in your heart. For at least 4 months now, you have been attending online catechism classes. Father told me just now. I am sure you have added the prayers. You have learned about Christian faith. 2-3 days back, maybe, or yesterday, I do not know. You have received the sacrament of reconciliation. You have prepared your heart to receive your King of Hearts. And now you are eagerly waiting to receive Jesus in your hearts. Jesus also is eagerly waiting to come into your hearts, my dear children. When you take one step to come close to Him, He takes 2 steps towards you. When you walk towards Him, He is running towards you. So much eager He is to come into your hearts. That much love Jesus has for you all. In a short while from now, He will come into your heart and He will reside in your hearts. Once He comes in your hearts, can you sit idle? Okay, first Holy Communion is over. So no more catechism classes, no Sunday classes, Sunday Eucharist, nothing else for. Can you say that? Can you sit idle? No one in the house speaks to you, talks to you. How do you feel? You will say to your mother or father, and you will say, no, mama, I do not stay here. Grandfather and grandmother, my mother and uncle, all of them are very, very busy. I don't want to stay in this house. Within 2 days, you will come back to your own dad and mom's house. Even Jesus will feel the same. Once he comes into your heart,
then we will do anything to please him. When we love a person,
love Him with all our heart, with all our mind, and with all our will. Amen.
We pray for our kings and our men, Reverend
pray for our personal intentions. Heavenly Father, we thank you for sending your beloved Son, Jesus, to be our Lord and King. We believe that whatever we ask in prayer, you grant it to us. Help us yearn for this kingdom, make us worthy of its citizenship, and grant us a strong desire to live and work for that kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant a peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with us.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy of the rich life of the Lamb, but blessed is the Lord.
May the body and blood of Christ be saved from the life.
Lord, have
Thank you.
Application form will be available on the school website. Thank you. Thank you.